giving you an opportunity to get the full story from the people who tell it best. This is Mediacom News Leaders.
I'm Don West, and this is Mediacom News Leaders. We're joined now by Rob Blevins, Executive Director of the Discovery Center, Springfield's Downtown Science Museum. Rob, welcome back to you, sir.
Well, thank you. It's good to be here again, Don.
Special anniversary for the Discovery Center. It's the 20th year, and you've already passed that anniversary, and it's a pretty special time of year.
Yeah, 20 years of being in operations as we know the Discovery Center now. And so over that course, we've had over a million visitors come into the Discovery Center. So it's a pretty good thing to celebrate that we've made it 20 years. We have a huge building, 60,000 square feet, and it's kind of crazy to think at one point that none of that existed, that we didn't have the Discovery Center, and what a sad time to not have the Discovery Center. So I don't want to think beyond those 20 years when we didn't exist, but I'm sure happy to celebrate that we've made it these 20 years.
It's not just for kids. You have adult events there too, and it's something for everybody to enjoy.
Yeah, so our mission is actually, it doesn't have kids anywhere in it. It's lifelong love of learning. We're trying to promote that and encourage that. And so we want people of all ages to come in and enjoy the museum, and we see that people do.
Got an event coming up December 1st to celebrate the holidays, the Festival of Trees, and it is back after a three-year absence.
Yeah, so it's actually the 31st annual now Festival of Trees. We're saying annual now because I think we're going to keep bringing it back. We brought it back originally to celebrate that. The funny part is when you say 31st annual and this is our 20th anniversary, obviously there's some years difference in that. So the Discovery Center for years was trying to get started and they started doing science lessons for people. During that time, Elfindale Manor, there were some residents there that decided to start a fundraiser for this, what would become the Discovery Center.
Okay.
And so that's when the Festival of Trees started. It actually started at Elfindale, and now we get it here at the Discovery Center.
And what's the idea behind it?
It's all around the holidays, so we'll have holiday decor that we're going to auction off. It's a traditional gala, so of course there'll be food, wine, beer, live entertainment. We'll have a flute and violin duo that's going to be doing Christmas music for us, and then the Missouri State Baritones are going to be performing a set, and then we'll be auctioning off some live decor. We're also going to have Moon Rocks there to celebrate that as well, on loan from NASA. So that's going to be fun. That our attendees will get to play with Moon Rocks and learn more about that.
Right.
It's going to be a great night.
This is on December 1st at the Discovery Center. What about the cost and where the money goes?
So the money goes to support the Discovery Center. We're a nonprofit, community-funded science museum, so events like this are critical for us being able to stay open. The cost will be $100 per ticket or $150 to be there for during the VIP hour as well.
So it's about auctioning off certain items?
Yeah, not just trees. We will have trees, but
okay,
there will be wreaths and other items as well that we'll live auction.
Trees that are already decorated?
Pre-decorated for you.
Do they get delivered?
Yes, we'll even deliver them. And we're not going to make people take them home with them that night. We want to keep them a little bit longer because they're so pretty.
Why did it disappear for 3 years?
Well, we switched and started doing the night at the museum. We wanted to have a mission-driven fundraiser piece where people, adults, you know, that lifelong love of learning, we got adults to come in and enjoy the Discovery Center that way. But we haven't really had that traditional gala piece as well. And so we want to bring that back to also, you know, have that fun gala piece as well.
Rob, what about special events coming for the kids in the winter and then into the spring?
Well, this winter we have some really fun stuff coming. One thing I'm not allowed to talk about yet, I should know within the next month whether we're going to have that. But one thing that we are working on right now is a 9-hole mini golf setup in our traveling exhibits area. We're going to build 9-hole science-themed holes.
Science-themed holes.
And teach science lessons, the physics behind, you know, how to actually get a hole in one. It takes science to be good at things like golf and sports, you know, and so I think that's a great way to get kids excited about science.
Kids, this is how you read the break on a...
Exactly. That's what we're going to help teach, and hopefully that'll encourage them to get better scores, and it'll just be a fun thing to add to the center. We're all about having fun.
Okay. This Festival of Trees on December 1st, what's the time frame on it?
The VIP hour is going to start at 5, and then doors will open up for general admission tickets at 6.
You can go online to discoverycenter.org/FOT for Festival of Trees and get the information about this, and you can buy your tickets when you get there?
You buy them beforehand.
Oh, okay.
This is definitely going to sell out. It's a very For as many years as we've had supporters, over 20 years, there are quite a lot of people that will be wanting these tickets.
Rob, great stuff from the Discovery Center as always. Thanks for being here.
Well, thanks again, Rob.
And join us next time here on Mediacom News Leaders.